Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to add a custom font to your GoDaddy website in 2024. So we're going to learn how to add a custom font. Custom fonts can give you site or can give your site a unique look and feel, making it stand out and better represent your brand. So make sure to follow this step-by-step guide to easily add custom fonts to your GoDaddy website in 2024. So make sure to stick by and let's get started. Before we start with this video, make sure to watch us from now till the end so you have full experience. First, you will need to go and open a browser. Here, for me, I'm using Brave. For you, you can use whatever you want. And all you need to do, go to this URL section. Basically, go first of all to godaddy.com, hit the enter button. But before, make sure your custom font is ready. If it's not, of course, make sure to go and download it from wherever like websites you download fonts from. So here's an example. For me, I'm already logged in. That's why I find my username at the top right corner. For you, if it's your first time and you're logged or you're not logged into your account, you'll find the sign in option here. Click on it to sign in into your account. If you don't have an account, if you click on it, you'll find at the bottom like a sign up option to create an account. Click on it to create an account. You can use Google, Microsoft, and Facebook if you don't want to get through all the boring steps of creating or even logging into your account. So once you're logged in, you'll find yourself here. So make sure to first of all access the website builder of whatever website you want to change or add the custom font on. So I'll just click here on my username. Then I'll go and click on my products. I'll find like my, as you can see, websites here. So all I need to do, I'll just click on one of those websites. Of course, you may not find like your website there if you have like many websites. So all you need to do, just click in here and click on view all to view all the website to click on the specific one that you want. So once you are here, I'll just go and click on edit websites so I can access the websites builder. Of course, I just hit the right click and open new tab, so I don't want to change the dashboard tab. So once you are here, as an example, I'll just go to any text like this one. And as an example, I'll just hover it and what's about like this. Okay, sorry. So if I go here to headings, example, action button, if you want to add the action button, media, as example, about images and etc. So there is nothing about the font, as you can see. So if I go and click on it, there is nothing here. You can just make a like line over it, as you can see, or make it italic or make it bold or something like that. But how can I actually change the font? So let me just go and remove that. So if we go here again to like websites, and of course, I'll just go in here and click on back on any text. So normally the text like on description like that, you'll not be able to change font on. All I need to change the font on is something like this, which is going to be like the headings. Of course, not even this heading, like normally like something like that. Yeah, the top. So if you go and click on it, as you can see, you'll be able to go and change the font. So if you click on change the font here, as you can see, you find the defaults and you find a lot of fonts here. But what if you didn't find the font that you like? And as we said, we would like to add a new font. So what can we do? So if I go here, normally I go now to theme in the middle. Once I click there, as you can see, I'll find here colors and fonts. Once I click on fonts, as you can see, I'll find primary fonts. I can go and look for a lot of fonts here, secondary fonts. And if I keep scrolling, as an example, I'll keep finding the fonts. But I'll now find again the button of adding a font. If I even scroll down here, even if I do whatever it is, as you can see, there is nothing like changing the font or uploading my own font into GoDaddy. So first of all, to upload the font, you'll need to go to GoDaddy, of course, studio account. Basically, all you need to do is simply go a new tab, type studio.godaddy. Sorry, not Google. I don't know why did I type Google. So godaddy.com and hit the enter button. And of course, I will already be logged into my account because I'm logged into my like GoDaddy account. If you're not logged in, make sure to just go and log in. It should not take a lot of time. Now, enter your projects example here. Select the project that you want to work on. If you have no projects, just go and click on select or create a new one. And as an example here, you'll need to select first of all the text that you want to change. So an example, I have no text added, so I'll just add random text here. And now I'll just go and hover that text. And as you can see, once I hover that text or click on it, I go click on text and font. As you can see, I'll find a lot of fonts again. And I'll find in this add font option. So if I click on it, as you can see, confirm first of all your business name and industry. So I'll just give it that name, a bakery. Why not? Click on save. And of course, you can add logos, fonts, and etc. to it. So just go, I'll not add all of that. I'll just go to fonts. Of course, you can even change fonts for paragraphs and etc. Make sure to choose, of course, the exact store that you want to change here. So that's the same one. So for me, I'll just go here to fonts, click on add fonts. And basically here, you'll have to upload the fonts. Of course, where you're going to get the fonts from, I don't know. So I'll just go here and type fonts. Normally, I download from that fonts as you can, as example. Maybe I like this one, so all I need to do is simply download it as a file. Why not? So here, I'll just go click on add the fonts, go here and make sure. So yeah, of course, my bad. So let me just go back in here. Click on download and I'll just normally extract the files. I did not extract the files. So once I extract the files, it should be good to go. So now if I click on add, and as you can see, you have to upload this one, OTF. Click on it. As you can see, uploading fonts. Once it's uploaded, here is it, successfully uploaded. So my fonts, it's in there and I can use it right away. So if I go now here and click on it, click on the fonts, of course, you can simply use this font and it will be changed to that font. Now, of course, you can export it wherever you want, as PNG or whatever you want. And I guess you'll be able to use it here, even in this website. But if you can't, I don't know like what you can do exactly, but let me just go and check. Like, it should be in there. Just have to look for the same name that you uploaded. I guess it was this one. Yeah. And maybe, yeah, I guess it was this one. And it should be all good. So yeah, that's going to be it for me today. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you in the next video. So goodbye.